Hi guys, welcome to a new episode of our series History of the Church. Today we are going to talk about the events that followed the Council of Chalcedon. As we remember and we discussed in the previous episode that the Council of Chalcedon splitted the Christian world already into two big teams. One team which accepted and adopted the faith of the Council of Chalcedon, which is called the Chalcedonians, which are in today's world the Catholics and the Eastern Orthodoxy. While the other team, which was the non-Chalcedonians, are in today's world the Oriental Orthodox Church, including our Coptic Orthodox Church. As we can see here on the map on the screen, that there are some blue lines at the right from below. These are the non-Chalcedonian churches, and the rest of the map is representing the Chalcedonian churches. And actually, again, we can see on the left hand of the screen, or left side of the screen, we can see another picture that summarizes the different heresies that targeted the nature of our Lord Jesus Christ. And at the bottom, there is the heresy of your teachers, who taught that our Lord Jesus Christ had one nature, monophysite, which was labeled to the non-Chalcedonian churches after the Council of Chalcedon. But actually our faith states that our Lord Jesus Christ is meophysite. Meophysite means one single nature coming from two natures being united without separation, without confusion, or without alteration. This is almost the same faith of the Chalcedonian churches, but as I said, due to the difference between Latin and Greek words, the confusion had happened. But thanks God that a declaration of faith was signed between the Chalcedonian and non-Chalcedonian churches in the late 80s of the 20th century, confirming that. But after the council, charges was mutually exchanged between the two teams. And I will show you now on the screen three icons that represent these mutual charges between the two teams. The first icon represents the Miaphysite. We will see that our Lord Jesus Christ is wearing two colors. The red color representing his humanity, and the blue color is representing his divine. And we will also see our Lord Jesus Christ is doing this through his right hand. We can see together, I can show it to the camera here. This is the letter I, and this is the letter C, and this is the letter X, which means Isos be Christos, or Jesus Christ. So he is stating his name and the two natures divined in one person without confusion, alteration, or separation. The second picture on the screen, we will see our Lord Jesus Christ holding one finger like this. He should be saying, I am, as was stated in the Gospel of St. John several times. But the Chalcedonian team accused us that this means that our Lord saying, I have one nature, monophysite. And on the other hand, we will see the other picture that the Lord is doing like this with two fingers. So the Chalcedonian team was accused that in this way the Lord is saying, I have two natures. And also if we look at the eyes, we will see one eye is wide open and the other one is a little bit closed. Also, they were accused that this represents, the wide eye represents the divine nature and the closed eye represented the human nature. But actually, this is the famous Christ Apantocrator icon, one of the oldest icons in the world right nowadays. It is found in the monastery of St. Catherine in Sinai. And the closed eye represents justice, while the opened eye is representing the mercy. So as you can see, the charges were mutually exchanged between the two teams, even through the art, which is actually bad. Later on, the Chalcedonian party continued like that, and they held three more ecumenical councils. The first ecumenical council they held, or the fifth according to their faith, is the Council of Constantinople, the second in the year 553 AD. And this council confirmed the church teachings regarding the two natures of Christ united in one person and condemned certain writings related to Nestorius and Eutyches. Later on, the Council number 6, which is Constantinople the Third, was held in Constantinople in the year 680, and this council discussed the monotheist controversy. In simple words, Jesus Christ had one or two wills. And finally, the Seventh Council, according to the Chalcedonian team, was held in the city of Nicaea in the year 787, and this council discussed the iconoclast controversy. In other words, should we worship the icons, or the icons is a man's dynamic way of expressing divine through art? This was the three councils. And actually, as you can see, those three councils did not add any new to Orthodox faith. And because as well the non-Chalcedonian team was not represented in these three councils, all the non-Chalcedonian churches, including our church or the Oriental Orthodox, rejected those three councils. We don't confirm except the first three ecumenical councils, Nicaea, Constantinople, and then Ephesus. The two teams continued this way until the year 1054, where the Chalcedonian team splitted as well into two teams, the Roman Catholic and the Roman Orthodox, or the Eastern Orthodox, which is known historically as the Great Schism. What were the reasons for the Great Schism? Shortly, the two chairs, Rome and Constantinople, were fighting about who has the higher authority, or who has the papal authority, which one is the first among equal, which one is the higher than the other. This was one reason. Another reason, there were some differences between the Greek theology used by the Eastern churches and the Latin theology also used by the Western churches. In addition also to that, there was some clause added to the Orthodox creed, which is known as the Filioque clause. It was added in the Roman Church or the Western Church, which says that the Holy Spirit proceeds from both the Father and the Son. And we refuse this because we know that the Holy Spirit proceeds only from the Father, as was written in the Gospel of St. John, and this was also the same face of the Eastern Orthodox churches. So, at the end of these differences between the two teams, in addition to other reasons, the bishop or the Pope of Rome excommunicated the Pope of Constantinople, and the other way around happened as well, and that led to the split of the church again in the year 1054 into two big teams, the Roman Catholic Church and the Eastern Orthodoxy, and that was what was known as the Great Schism. If you look at the chart on the screen, you will see that these are the main Christian denominations in our today's world. You can see Catholic in red, about 1.2 billion followers, the Protestant 600 to 800 millions, the Eastern Orthodoxy around 200 millions, and the Oriental Orthodox at 82 million. And the yellow line at the bottom, as I said, this is the Assyrian Church, which is the Nestorian Church in Iraq. Finally, in the following table, we conclude the major differences between the Oriental Orthodox, or the non-Chalcedonian team, including our church, and the Eastern Orthodox, or the Chalcedonian team. We have here some points of comparison. For example, the Christology. Our church, the Oriental Orthodox Church, says that we believe in one nature of the Lord Jesus Christ, resulted from the unity between two natures, the divine and the human, without separation, without confusion, and without alteration. The other team, the Eastern Orthodox team, believe in two natures of Christ united in one person without separation, without confusion, and without alteration. Concerning the ecumenical councils, our church and the Oriental Orthodox churches believe only and confirms only three councils, the first three councils, while the other team confirms and accepts the seven ecumenical councils they had. Concerning the liturgy, we had three main liturgies, the liturgy of St. Basil, the liturgy of St. Cyril, and the liturgy of St. Gregory. And we fast around 9 hours before communion, while on the other party they have the liturgy of St. John Chrysostom and the liturgy of St. Basil, and they fast only 3 hours. Concerning the marriage is a sacrament in our church, and it happened only between believers from the same denomination inside the church, while the other party accept marriages between the different denominations, but it is also a sacrament and it must happen inside the church. Finally, the sign of the cross. We draw the sign of the cross like this: in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. And they do it this way: in the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God, Amen. So we do it from the left to the right, while they do it from the right to the left. And both teams have different explanations for that. For example, the Oriental Orthodox Church say that moving from the left to the right means that the Lord Jesus Christ moved us from darkness to light, while the other team, the Eastern Orthodox, say that our Lord Jesus Christ moved the face from the Jews, which represent the right, to the Gentiles, which are represented by the left. These are more references if you want to dig deeper on the topics that we discussed in today's episode. Thank you for watching. See you in the next episode. Pray for us. Bye.